Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Arm Wrestling Simulator, where today we are starting over as a big old noob, as you can see, with just 7 strength to our name, and we also have the official noob title, but we have some tricks up our sleeve to hopefully reach the new final world in the game, which is now the Roman Empire, and of course, that would be using the new best and most OP pet on this completely noob account. Now, we don't have the pet on this account, and that's because it's over here on my main account, which also happens to be in the same lobby. Now, this account is, it's a little bit better. I don't think you could quite say it's a noob. And the pet in question is the newly released free to actually obtain Soldier Dominus pet with a 1.45 billion multiplier, which is about 2 times stronger than the pet I last did this challenge with. And there's even more tricks we have up our sleeve to hopefully progress even faster. All right, we have the items in our inventory, the 1.4 billion Soldier Dominus, as well as some best friend egg glowing reindeers to use alongside it, because these have an enchant called best friend 8, and this enchant means the pet will always be 160% as powerful as my best pet, and 160% of our best pet means these pets are now 2.3 billion, and so with just 3 pets, we're starting off with a 6 billion total overall stat team on a complete noob account. Holy crap, this is broken. All right, so we could say goodbye to our main account, because that's all we need from him, and on this noob account, we won't be buying any game passes, we won't be buying any potions, none of that, because I want the true noob experience, and within just a few curls, we already have enough strength to absolutely demolish the best boss here in World 1, and that's not really a surprise. Now, usually the biggest issue for these challenges is getting wins. It's super slow on an account like this with no winner pets or no wins potions, but recently, the game came out with a code 1 million. When you type this in, you get a 48-hour all-stat boost, a 3x stat boost, which you might be thinking is just strength, but it's actually wins, so we now have a permanent 3x wins boost for the rest of this challenge, which should help us progress through things so much faster. It does also affect strength, so now our team is basically a 15 billion strength multiplier team with just 3 pets on this brand new noob account. Absolute insanity. I know, this game just keeps getting wackier and wackier. But there we go, 15,000 wins. We can escape the school, head through the garden that no one uses, and waltz our way into the second gym, which do we already have? We already have enough strength, oh my gosh, to fight the number one boss. We haven't even trained any strength here, and we're, oh my gosh, we're gonna beat him in like 3 wins. We're gonna get enough wins within 3 fights. And we're already out of here. Bro, what the heck? We didn't even have to train any strength. Yeah, man, these pets keep getting so freaking absurdly OP. I don't even know how to handle it. Now, we haven't opened any arms crates. Do we have enough wins? Oh, we can almost get that silver crate there. I think we're gonna purchase a trail first and then start working on this punching bag. And wow, instantly, without even an arm, without any rebirths, we already are strong enough to beat the bet. Wait, this is not the best boss. I'm super sorry, this is not the best boss, but we can already beat the best boss, the Kraken. The Kraken only needs 1.5 QA. I always forget, every time I do these challenges, I always forget how easy it is to obtain the strength. The strength is never the hard part for these challenges, it's these wins. On maps like this, right here, we have to defeat the Kraken boss. We're getting 50 billion wins, but we need 5 trillion to escape. So I think we have to beat the Kraken boss, I think it's 50 times to get out of here, and there's like no way around it. I'm obviously trying to get winner pets in a little bit to help me get some wins boost to make these fights faster, but as you can see, we only need to get strength for like 15 seconds, and then that's like the hard part done. But man, ah, dude, these challenges are always so fun, and you guys love them as well. They're like the most popular videos on the channel as well, so huge thanks for all the support on this series over the last few months on the game. But yeah, I'll catch you guys in a few minutes when we've got enough wins to move on to the bunker.
A few moments later.
Alrighty, 5.5 trillion wins later, we can skedaddle our way onto the nuclear bunker, and we have unlocked some new training methods, and now we get an astonishing, oh, only 5 QA per curl. But again, we haven't rebirthed a single time, so we can spam out some of these wins here. I don't want to spam too many wins. There we go. We now have a 700% rebirth, so now we get 45 QA strength per curl. We also haven't opened a single arm crate, so we can open or buy a few golds, open up all of these, see what arms we're going to get, 350% arm. So now technically, whoa, jeez, that was huge. You're getting 2.2 QI per curl. Just some small bumps. Same thing for the trail. We can go from a 150% trail to a 235% trail, and we're up to 4 QI strength. And would you look at that? We only need 149. Within 2.18 seconds, we can already demolish the Mutant King here and move on. I think it's really a combination between the 3x stat boost and just the brokenness of Best Friend 8 and this Soldier Dominus pet. But I want to see, how many wins do we get from beating the Mutant King? I always forget this stat. So we got 1.4 QI. We need 50 QI to move on. So I think this is where I might actually get a few wins and then maybe try to get some base winner pets, because this is really where things start slowing down. I might also start getting, dang it. Okay, I said I wasn't buying anything, but because I'm a lazy YouTuber, the only thing I'm buying is a teleport game pass. Listen, I'm being honest about this. I'm being open and honest. The only thing I'm buying is this game pass just because I'm super lazy and I don't want to have to run back through all these portals and it's super slow. And I've done it one too many times on one too many challenges, but obviously it doesn't have any gameplay or challenge impact. It's just me being super lazy. But okay, let's go ahead and get some pets, some random pets here from this egg. What are we gonna get? Oh, Arctic Fox. What are we gonna get? Oh, Arctic Fox. Wait, can we get three? Oh no, we can't get three Arctic Foxes. Dang it. All right, so we're basically, oh, winner three. That's pretty much perfect. Thank you. And then we're gonna need to rebirth again, but not use up all of our wins, because that would be quite bad, but get kind of close. It was a little too close. Another winner three. Oh, and a winner four. I will take that. So with these pets, that gives us, I believe, a 70% wind boost. But because of the 3x wind boost, we now have like a total of like a 5x wind boost. So if we go ahead and equip this wind team, let's go ahead and make a just a really quick strength team as well. Equip this, go and fight the Mutant King. Oh no, I have no strength. Dang it. Okay, that's not like it's really a problem or anything. All right, how many wins can we get now? I think it was 700 QI, 1.2 QI. Nice, per win. That is pretty huge. So yeah, we only need to beat this guy around 30 times and we can move on to world five. So there's 8 worlds currently in Arm Wrestling Simulator. They just added a new one, I believe a week or two ago. So that is the goal for this video, to get to world 8. And we are currently in world 4, but obviously we're making really quick progress. The only thing here is just the winner pets. I think in a moment I might go through and try to unlock as many pets as I can, because if I'm able to index a bunch of pets, I get an extra pet equip, which means an extra winner pet and an extra strength pet. But we'll see if I need it when we get to world 5 in just a second. All right, 55 QI wins. Let's skedaddle our way onto world 5, and we already have enough strength to beat the mammoth. So I'm just gonna do a quick test to see how many wins do we get from Mr. Mammoth over here. Come on. We get 892 QI wins. Ooh, that is not good. That is not good, because I don't know if you guys know, we need around 500 SX wins. So we have to beat this guy 500 times. That's a lot of times, if you're asking me. That's a whole lot of times. So I think it would probably be worth it if we went back and tried to get an extra pet equip, because then we can try to get another winner pet, which then maybe makes this like a 6x wins boost. And then is there a way to get a double wins potion? I'm trying to think. I feel like before I've had like a double wins potions and like these daily gifts or something. I don't know. Let me, is there a code? Let me go check. Oh, there's a few double wins codes. So if we type in 500 million, does it work? Oh, 2x wins for 5 hours. So now if we go back, the way this works is it should stack on top of each other. So this should be giving us like pretty much like two SX per win. Let's put on our little auto clicker, make him go crazy. Yeah, 1.7 SX wins is actually a huge improvement. So there's not much else we could do other than getting an extra pet equip. And it seems like we have upwards of like 20 hours of codes up for wins boost, so that's really good. But I'm gonna go ahead and try to get that extra pet equip to see if we can't get that up to 2 SX wins every time we beat that boss. And man, the codes are almost like simulator. At least right now, starting out as a new player, if you use the codes to your advantage, you can progress pretty far pretty fast. And when I started out, these codes, most of these codes didn't exist, and a lot of them, all of them to my knowledge, still work. And so if I were you guys, I would just look up a list on Google of like arm wrestling simulator codes, and they're definitely out there, and they will definitely help you out. And then also this other trick that I'm using, this pet index machine machine over here in the spawn gym. As you can see, it says find 39 more pets for plus one pet equip. So basically, I'm just going back through all of these eggs that I haven't opened so far because I didn't need any of these pets. And every time I find a new pet, then it will add it to that index over there. So now we need to find 38 new pets. And then this will be a new pet, water mage. Now we need to find 37 new pets. So once we find a total of 37 new pets, then we will get an extra pet equip completely for free permanently. And I don't know if there's another way to get a free pet equip other than just grinding that. There used to be during the Christmas event a ton of free pet equips, but I think those have all gone away now. And bada bang, we just got ourselves an extra free pet equip. So now we can try to go get ourselves honestly, I think a winner 4 would be kind of cool. And there we have it. Winner 4 pet has been secured. And I think now, does that mean we have a 12x wins boost all for free? Because our winner team is a 2x wins boost. And then that stacks with this 3x wins boost. That's 6x. And then this 2x wins boost potion doubles that. So that's 2x times 6x. So we should have a 12x wins boost for free for the rest of this challenge, which is crazy. Okay, let's make sure strength team is on. Looking a little weak here. There we go. Let's get some real rebirth strength up in here. What can we get up to? Oh yeah, 1500 seems about pretty decent. Let's see arms. Ah, dude, we still don't even have any diamond crates? Jeez. All right, we're getting a solid 2.1 SX wins every time we defeat the mammoth. So we just have to sit here for another around 200 fights or maybe 225 fights. And then we'll be merrily on our way to World 6. And so far we haven't had the super rebirth or do anything annoying like that. I really hope we don't, because then we'll have to do this process all over again. And it's really, really gonna draw things out. But we'll just kind of play by ear and see how things are when we get to World 6 and then eventually World 7. Oh my goodness, it took quite a long time, but we have done it. 500 SX wins means we can skedaddle on to World 6, which, oh, I completely forgot they changed how this looks. And we can go ahead and train. I think hand grips are the best in this world. And then let's make sure we have on our strength team. And then let's make sure our trails are nice and updated as well. Get a little bit of a boost. This is where things definitely do start. How do we still have no diamond crates? What the heck? Oh, I only have a 0.2% chance of finding it in World 5. But still, I mean, this is a chance. Oh, no. This has to work. Okay. We just tried to make 3 arms golden. Failed on the first 2, and only the last one worked. But now we have a 525% arm, which is a bit of a boost. Oh, dude, I shouldn't have rebirthed. Whoa, I shouldn't have rebirthed. Jeez. That got me like nothing at all. What the heck? Yeah, so arms, trails, pets. We've pretty much got everything maxed out to the gills at the moment. And in order to beat the final World 6 cybernetic boss, oh, we only need 1.4 SX strength. Oh, they nerfed the crap out of this guy. I think you used to need like 2.8 something strength. But yeah, they cut it in half, which is a big help. It's just that usually it's at these moments where I just try to think to myself, like, what can I? Is there anything that I can do to, you know, speed up the process of me getting out of here a little bit faster? But I don't think so. I think this is the fastest training method. It seems a little bit slow, but it's probably because we only have 4 pet equips. And even though this thing is really powerful, having 4 pet equips is definitely the main drawback at the moment. Also, same thing with this arm. If we were able to get some diamond or platinum crates, then we'd be able to probably get upwards of like 1000% arm, which would be a really big help. Now, there is another trick I'm hiding up my sleeve, but I'm saving that for World 7, and that should be able to probably double our total strength whenever we need to. But again, I gotta save that for World 7. Can't use that just at the moment. I should have done this earlier on. I should have got at least like a few super rebirths, because not having any, I'm definitely sort of regretting it. It would have taken a little bit of time, but not too long, because now it's gonna take me forever to get back to this point. And yeah, there's a part of me, man. There's a part of me. I know I should have super rebirthed, but I've done it way too many times. I don't want to keep doing it. All right, well, we'll sit here and train up strength until we have probably around 1.6 SX strength, just a little bit over the required amount. So that way we could beat the boss a little bit faster. Then we'll be on to World 7, which is previously where these challenges would have ended. But World 7, I might have to spend upwards of like a day there of like real world time grinding out strength, grinding out wins, because we need like 20. 20 SP strength, and at the moment, we have around 200 QI strength, so we've got a long ways to go in order to escape World 6, go to World 7, and escape World 7, so I'm looking forward to the challenge, but whew, this might be a long one.
20 minutes later.
Well, after a quick 20 minutes, we have 1.8 SX strength. Is this enough? I mean, I do know it should be enough. Oh, this is a slow fight, though. Jeez, Cybernetic is really putting up a fight here, and we do get 3 SP wins every time we beat him, so looks like we're only gonna need to beat him around 30 more times in order to move on to World 7, which is where I think we're going to be spending maybe upwards of 2 more, like, I don't even know, maybe 2 more days here, just to get the final amount of strength we need. We're gonna need a lot of strength, and again, like I said, I've got some tricks up my sleeve, but I can't really use those until the very end. Alrighty, one more win is all we need to escape to World 7, and I think we got that in the bag. So bye-bye World 6. I don't really like it. Not too fond of it, but World 7, I have spent a long, long time here, so I hope to not spend too much longer here, but I have a feeling we are going to be in for quite a grind session here in World 6 or World 7, because in order to move on from World 7 to World 8, we need 20.7 SP total wins or total strength, and at the moment, we have 1.9 SX strength. Now, there's a few things right off the bat we can do to immediately get more strength. First off is arms. We still are just really down bad on our arms, but luckily, when you're in World 7, you have a 1% chance to get a diamond key and a 24% chance to get a gold crate key. So definitely training up to get some strength to beat this beginner boss is a must. But then I also think going back and getting another pet equip so that we can use all 5 of our pets here would be a big boost. And I mean, we can purchase an extra trail, but like, this is where these trails really stop mattering. And just like that, we have secured our 5th and final free pet equip of the challenge. But geez, man, even while I was doing that, triple X strength, we've got, you know, over 10 billion total stats chilling here. There's really nothing else we can use. We can open some lucky blocks and just like see if we'll get anything. We probably won't get anything of use other than just like, you know, basic items. But I mean, those wins are kind of useful, but it's a little bit too late to rebirth if you ask me. So for the first time, getting strength is basically our biggest challenge, but we're finally unlocking these big old barbells over here, which, oh, these do so much more than those dumbbells. Jeez, okay, we might be in a little bit better hands, but still, I mean, yeah, this number up top is going up, but this strength number isn't really going up, and that's what we really need to be climbing here. So let's see, this final barbell is gonna get us 454 QA per curl, but we also have about 150% of strength boost we can also get, so this could get close to around 1 QI per curl. We could also get a bunch of alt accounts added and joined up in this lobby just to, again, pretty much double the amount of strength we'd be getting from this, which might be worth it, because again, it's completely free, and it just might be necessary, because geez, this is a whole lot slower than I anticipated. Now, the final trick I have up my sleeve is there's a ton of codes out there that when I enter them, they should around double my strength, maybe even increase it by 1.5x, but I need to wait until I have around 10 SP strength in order to use it, because if I put it in now, it'll take me from 4 to 8x strength, so I can only use these codes once and one time only, and so I basically have to wait till I have 10 SP strength, and at this current rate, ooh, it is gonna take quite a bit of time. Now, also, our arms is severely lacking. Like, in this platinum crate, there is, for example, a buff chrono arm, which is, like, pretty easy to obtain 5%, and the golden version of this is over 1200%, so that is more than double our best arm. So again, that would double our strength, but in World 7, we only have a 0.5% chance of getting a platinum key whenever we defeat a boss, and at the moment, we don't even have enough strength to defeat a boss, so that also seems to be a bit of a problem. I could super rebirth about 15 times, and that in itself would about double the rate at which I'm getting strength, and if I want to beat this challenge, I just might have to do it because at this rate, getting 10 SP strength is basically 10,000 SX. And it seems like it would take almost like a week of AFKing, and that's just a little too long. So I think I made a mistake. I should have super rebirth grind earlier on, but you know what? We made it here. We got the fifth pet equip, which will help us. So before we start super rebirthing a bunch, I'm gonna go ahead and get one last winner pet, because that will also greatly help us out. All right, and with that, we can do some rebirths and start this super rebirth grind that I should have done a while ago. It'll probably only take like 30 minutes, but I'm just kind of pissed because I have to go all the way back through world 5, all the way back through world 6, which will probably take like an hour and a half, which I should have already done this, and that's why I'm a little upset. So I'm just kind of breeze through this process, show you guys a little glimpse into it, but probably not show you everything because it is super boring. All right, 500 SX wins later. We are back again to World 6, our very familiar home. And I think we're gonna go ahead and use up all of our rebirths because this is probably the max strength we're gonna get. I think we had 1500% before, so getting up to around 3200% is basically doubling the amount of strength we're able to get, which is huge. Oh, and we also have 2 diamond crit keys. That's also really big. What are we gonna get? Oh, a 600% arm. Very slight increase, but an increase nonetheless. Okay, we are finally back to World 7, and with the biggest barbell, we now get 1.5 QI, which is crazy because were we just getting 250 QA? How does that? Some math ain't math, and I don't know. My arm is slightly better, and my pets are basically the same. I don't know, but we're getting significantly more strength. Obviously, I know our strength boost is a lot higher, which I guess means I really need to do the friends boost thing now, because then I'd be getting a total of like 3 QI. But I want to do a quick test to see how long it takes to gain 1 SX strength while curling 1.5 QI, just so that I know how long we can expect for us to have to sit here and grind all of this out. Yeah, so it takes just about a minute to get 1 SX strength. So if we got 3 SX strength, it'll take about 30 seconds. And so it seems like if I got a full friends boost and just sat my butt right here, it would take probably 2 full days of AFKing to get to the strength required. And that's also assuming that I'm going to be able to get a strong enough arm. And so somewhere along the line, I'm going to have to sit down and AFK a boss for quite some time because I will need at least like 1000% arm, or maybe probably that 1200% arm at this point. All right, so I'm going to go do that, train for like a day or so, and hope I come back with a whole lot of strength.
48 hours later.
Well, gamers, it has been 48 hours of us AFKing strength, and as you can see, we currently have 7.1 SP strength, and there's just 3 things left to do to see if I can hit 20 SP strength to beat Dr. Propulsion and move on to World 8 and to complete this challenge, the first of which is actually picking up a new trail. Now, we are very close to being able to afford this lightning trail, and I didn't realize we were actually so close to being able to afford it, so I want to see if we put on our winner team. Oh, we don't have any more. Oh, we have no more boost at all. How many wins are we gonna get for beating the Lair Guardian? If it's like not even 1-0 wins. Oh, 1.10 wins. Perfect. This means we can just beat him a few more times, get enough wins to get that slightly better trail, because that should help us out a ton when it comes to getting us more strength, because I kind of forgot that I really hadn't upgraded my trail in quite some time. All right, that should be enough wins. Yeah, 214.80. Go ahead and pick up the lightning trail, and we'll go ahead and just train, and we're up to 10.3 SP. That's perfect, because now we have just a few platinum and diamond crates to open. And I know this isn't a lot of crates, but honestly, I don't know if we're gonna need a lot of crates. Okay, let's go see what we got. We got 1 buff chrono. Oof. Okay, so we're gonna definitely need to get one of these arms golden, and that should help us out a ton. I definitely didn't grind bosses as long as I should. I probably spent like an hour or so grinding bosses when I could have spent longer. Oh, that is perfect. A 1000% golden chrome arm puts us up to 16 SP strength. Let's freaking go. Now all that's left for us to do is to go ahead and type in the remaining of the arm wrestle simulator codes that we haven't typed in, and there is a lot. So that's +5%, that's +5%, that's +5%, that's another +5%, that's gonna be +10%. That's plus 15%. This should be another, geez, plus 15%. Golly. Rockets. We've already used one of these codes. Can't remember which one. We haven't used that one, though. 600 and visit. Another plus 5. We're already at 31 SP strength. And we can demolish them. So, oh my gosh. And then Merry Xmas is the last code, but it doesn't work. So 31 SP. We basically doubled our total strength just from these codes alone. And then from the trail and the arm, we just went from 7 SP to 30 SP. Bada bang, bada boom. That is just absolute insane. I can't believe it. Let's move on to the final world. Oh, wait. I just realized getting one in wins. He gives me 5.20 wins. So, okay. We are going to have to beat this guy like 200 times. And this is kind of crazy. Like, if I just don't touch it, we're kind of barely winning, which is really weird. So, we're going to have to pull out the OP auto clicker and go to town on him. But I think, let me just double check. So, we beat Dr. Propulsion. And then we need one in win. So, I have to beat him 200 times. But then the challenge will be done starting as a noob, spending 0 Robux in the account, obviously, minus the teleport game pass, and making it to World 8 all in about 3 days' time. It's pretty impressive, but this challenge was a lot. It was a lot of work, a lot of planning went into it, but I'll see you guys after we beat this guy about 200 times.
Many hours later.
Well, 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 would you look at that, one in wins later, we can skedaddle our booties on out of here and say goodbye to the Space Center and hello to the Roman Empire with 31 SP strength. Now, if we wanted to beat this guy 147, this would take like a whole week of AFKing, and we're not going to do that. So I think I'm just going to trade back this pet to my main account, call this challenge a success, and a big thanks to anyone who has stuck to the end of this video. This is a super fun challenge, and I'm glad I've got some new tough challenges with an arm wrestling simulator to tackle. As always, hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you did, don't forget to drop a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Deuces!